I'm John. I work in Google Checkout. And this lightning talk is more of a sort of a reaction I saw. I mean, I had when I was actually looking at the talk this morning about the DSLs. I know someone spoke about DSLs. Very interesting talk. And I think some of the key points that he highlighted was the ability to sort of give a very business-like language approach to testing, which is kind of cool. But my talk is focused on that not being the only reason why people should use DSLs. And I have a case in point, an example to prove that. So in the beginning, there was JWeb unit. All is nice and happy. Everyone was pretty happy with the test. They were running pretty fast. We had lots and lots of tests, and they all used JWeb unit under the hood. Unfortunately, the application that we were testing started using more and more JavaScript. Oh no, JWeb unit doesn't support JavaScript as well, as we learned. But there's always hope. And by some magic tool developed by some friends we know, we had Selenium. So cool. So now we had Selenium to test our JavaScripty application. Excellent. That sounds like a great idea. Except that's a lot of tests that we had that were using JWeb unit. Aha, DSLs for the rescue. Because when someone told me, so are we going to migrate all these tests? No, sir, that's not going to happen. I'm not going to sit and migrate 4,000 tests that I wrote in JWeb unit now to Selenium and then potentially to WebDriver or whatever new testing tool we come out with. And that's really the point of DSLs, because what we had is what we have is basically a common interface that we developed, sort of two levels of abstraction. So one is an abstraction over the testing engine itself, which meant that people could switch testing engines on the fly, and we can even do that now using a flag. And the second sort of level of abstraction is over the commands themselves. So the application itself has a language, which is the DSL, but under the hood you have an interface that allows you to switch, which means JWeb unit, Selenium, or insert your next cool testing tool or testing engine here, which is, I think, a perfect segue to the next talk. And I've just done about, pretty fast. So thank you.
Thank you.